is the stream that never ends. You think it's over, but then it starts all over again. Hello and welcome to the stream. Today's pre-stream pattern was a rendition of the song that never ends, but I wackily and humorously turned it into the stream that never ends, which of course the stream does end. This stream ends. The song about the stream ended when the stream started. So very meta there. Okay, last time on stream we were looking at neural networks, and that pretty much broke me. So we're not going to do that again. So we're going to sit this here and say not. We had a wonderful special guest, Fierce Crocodile, who I understand could be heard on the stream, which is great. That's what we wanted. And he attempted to help me, and he is a nice person, but I totally was effed over. Was not helped. Okay, so the time before last, or the penultimate time, actually that's probably not correct, because now the last time would be penultimate, and this is the last stream to date. We were looking at how to get Google to index our pages and consider them to be mobile friendly, because it said index them, but it's going to give us a big red exclamation point. And again, my purpose here is not to make my pages mobile friendly, but I just don't like Google giving me this, big white exclamation point in a red background in a circle. I could petition them to change the symbol and I'd be cool with it. But the other problem we had was we said, okay, we can edit our page until it does what Google needs it to do. But the problem is if we use Google Pages for the editing, the updates are not in real time. They're not even close to real time. Partly because I have to push them to GitHub Pages. But even after that, GitHub Pages takes a little bit of time to deploy them to the github.io site. And if we're making a lot of changes very rapidly, which we hope to do, that's not a good process for us. So what is the process we're going to use? Well, I do have a server called BC Info 3. I mean, that's what I call it. I think you probably would call it test.barrycarter.info. That's what the internet calls it. And I could, in theory, set up a place to sort of test stuff out. In fact, there is such a place called test, thus the name test.barrycarter.info. It's not very exciting. One problem here is, though, I kind of want to keep this account that I've created, and I forget who I am, Margaret Fontaine. God, I'm so amazingly cool. Yeah, the Margaret Fontaine account separate from the test.barrycarter.info, which I think might be claimed by my other Google account, the one I use for actual real-life indexing, to the extent that I have an actual website. So what we're going to do here is we're not going to be... I was looking for a free site yesterday that we could mess with. I do have DigitalOcean, but I don't think it's running a web server right now. So what we're going to do here is we're going to create a subdomain inside of BC Info 3 that lets us test in real time. The bogus part of that is we have to add that as a property, because right now Google thinks all of our pages are on barrycarter.github.io. And it occurs to me I maybe should have also changed this, because there's a very obvious connection now between Barry Carter and Maggie Fontaine. I think she likes to be called Maggie, because that is in her Google username. Plus, she's a made-up creature. She's a fictional creature I created, so I get to do that. So the first thing we do for that is we go into BC Info 3 here, which happens to be in my Git, because that's the way I like it. And we look at lighty.conf. This is not at all difficult. I have several different subdomains already, so we just need to copy one of these. So let's just copy one of these. And what's probably interesting here is we probably don't even need to set a CGI assigned, because this is going to be GitHub pages are HTML only, so whatever the hell I do here has to be HTML only, otherwise I'll have pages that are not compatible. So let's do this, and we'll call it Maggie Testing, and we'll say that if you go to, okay, so we've got to be careful here, so if you do anything dot, yeah, I think I can do this correctly, yeah, over here, this is just anything.map.anything. Pretty much dot anything. So this is it's very wide. So here, I think we'll just call this Maggie for right now, and call this Maggie. Don't need that. For this to work, of course, we now need to create the Maggie subdirectory. But again, pretty much everything on the BC Info 3 is also in my GitHub. So we can go over here, BC Git BC Info 3, sites, and you can see I have a bunch of them right in here. So we're going to make one and go into it, call it Maggie. Yes, I do want to do that, but that's not the important part. Now, well, we need to now push this conf file over to BC Info 3, and we need to restart Lighty to get this to read the conf file. Neither of these is a huge deal, but let me go ahead and do that. That I'm going to have to do on the other machine, but when we get back here, we're going to SSHF, I always get that wrong, secure shell mount the Maggie subdirectory there so we can make live changes to Maggie. And we might do something even more clever because I'm feeling more clever. But first, let's get these files over to BC Info 3. Let's restart it. Let's make sure I haven't broken anything. Unlikely. I probably have. So there's a chance this will bring down my web server. But I mean, I can always revert this change and unbreak it. I really don't care that much. I mean, it's like, you know, it's like, I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. Okay, let me see if there's an etc. init lighty. I get the feeling this won't do what I want, but, because I've actually forgotten how to restart lighty after I make a change. There might be some info here in readme. Again, everything here should be public. If there's something private here, it's my fault. By the way, I'm not using Apache on this server. I am using Lighty, which is a different web server. It's presumably a lighter version. It's not great because I can't find a way to use it with SSL. I mean, I'm sure you can do it, but the sort of the easy SSL that you can get doesn't have instructions for Lighty, and I don't completely understand how to get it to work with Lighty. So that's not a great choice that I necessarily made using Lighty there. By the way, Light HTTPD. This sucker here is pronounced Lighty, which is stupid. Okay, it is Pomodoro time, but of course, like as always, we're going to skip the first one. And we will also skip if there are guests who come in. Okay, so I don't think this is going to have instructions on how to... This is how to rotate the logs, which would certainly be a workable way of restarting HTTPD. And it might be what I really should be doing, but I'm pretty stupid. Okay, so there was some issues here earlier. All right, so now we've synced over. Let me go ahead and see if I can restart it. This is going to be bad news. I get the feeling that for some reason you can't do it in the way you think you can do it. But let me go ahead and check the logs to make sure. Again, this I'm on another machine. It does say server started, so I guess it's there. So now, even though I created this wonderful Maggie directory, the only thing this will let me do is go to Maggie. I could use barrycarter.info here, but I like using one of my short domains called, that's actually probably okay, because right now we don't have anything in that subdirectory. So now, how are we going to get this magic working? Oh, this is so ugly. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and make a mount directory here. I'm not root, so it's not a root mount. So it's this. And then I'm going to make a mount directory for Maggie. So I could have done this in one step. And now I'm going to... SSF... Yeah, this is... I think barrycarter.info resolves to the right. There's two barrycarter... See, one of them resolves to... Oh, that is the wrong one, actually. Because one of them have a WordPress site that's a different machine, and I think this is test is going to be the one I want, which ends in like 2.2. This is the correct one. So let's go ahead and now, SSFHS, this command here, I know, you're thinking, hey, you shouldn't do that as root, and I know I shouldn't, and I'm a terrible person, and you can hate me for it. Maggie on to Mount Maggie, which sounds like a mountain, but it is not. Now, of course, I type in the password. Ooh. Okay, because we've not connected to it before, we're going to do this. And the password, of course, is... Oh, I can't tell you that. Ooh, shit. I might have changed it. Yeah, hang on. Okay. Oh, God, I changed to something horrible. This is my own fault, of course. I mean... On the other hand, easy-to-type passwords would be no fun. Well, I mean, they'd be more fun, but less secure, I think, is what I meant to say. Okay, that's not cool. By the way, I could also use Emacs's SSHFS feature, which lets you edit remote files as though they were local. I'm tempted to do that, but I'm now curious as to why remote host has disk. Oh shit! I know why. Fuck. Okay. Oh, I just realized something else too. Because I'm a home user, this whole thing is mounted on another machine. So I'm going to try SSHF. Your mama. I'm going to try secure shell mounting from there, which means we'll have an SSHFS mount on top of an SSHFS mount, which is just gorgeous. Because actually here I can't do anything because my whole system is mounted somewhere else. So let's really F with this motherfucker. Mount Maggie. Okay, so it does exist here. I know you can't see what I'm doing. Okay, and I need to have special keys to do this SS... God damn it. To do this secure shell. And I'm trying to see what it is. Come on, baby needs a new pair of shoes. Okay. Hang on one second here. I know I've done this before. And again, this is one of the things where I say I've done this before, and I might not have done it with this exact machine, which is why I don't have the exact instructions for this machine. Let's see. Oh, crap. Wow. Okay. Well, it's not that hard. Let's see. Okay. So basically, I need to use my key here. So that's SSHFS, and then you have to give a special command for what your SSH command is, because we're being weird here. It's a pain in the ass, but it's not actually... it's not difficult, it's just tedious. That's what I like to say sometimes. Okay, so it is SSHFS minus O, and then you put in the... then you put in the the command that you need, which is with the key. God damn it. Fuck me. Okay, and there's my special key for this machine. Some people use the same key for all machines. That's not really that bad. But let's see. God damn it. This is the reason we can't have nice things. So this is again one of those delays that I don't really like having, but okay. Bad few. Okay, that's my bad there. Hang on one second. Unknown option. Okay, yeah, why the hell not? Okay, let me see if I can actually do it the way I want to from here. Um, And I know you can't see this. This is some engaging chatter for you. Let's see if anyone's in chat. Nope. So let's go ahead and do this. Oh, come on. It's being a pain in the freaking ass. Okay. Okay, I hope I can do it using the root password, but at the same time, I know that I shouldn't be doing that. So, kind of a double bad thing. I might have it restricted to this machine. Nope, doesn't like that. And I can almost definitely know why. Let's look at the logs here. I'm sure I'm going to get a security log saying, "Hey, you can't do that." Yep. Password auth succeeded. Okay. Password auth succeeded for root from my IP address. Disconnect received. That's not what I wanted. Okay. So let me just SSH over there and see what the hell's going on. It's theoretically possible I don't have SSHFS mounting set up. I should, though, because that's trivial. Okay, so I can log in with that password. Okay, so I guess the question is, do I have the thingy that I need? I need the receive side of SSHFS. Wow. Yum does not like me today. Okay, cool. I've broken Yum somehow over here. This is just getting worse and worse. And I have Dropbear installed here instead of on the other machine, instead of okay, so let's help you guys out here and help me out here. SS this using Dropbear, because I have Dropbear on the other machine, which is supposed to be more secure, though I think is well, this is the problem right there. So again, this is one of those things where they convinced me Dropbear was a perfect drop-in replacement for SSH, but it is not, motherfuckers. Oh my god. Okay. Motherfucker. God damn it. And these are the things that fail. Whoa. Let me see if I have a... I do have an SFTP daemon here. No, that's actually the wrong direction. That is a... That is an SFTP client program. I apparently do not have a server installed here. Now this is a nightmare. And since my Yum isn't working, and what's kind of weird here is there's a whole bunch of free space that I don't remember having, which suggests something terrible happened. But that's something I need to look at in a completely different light at a completely different time. Okay, so now that fucked up nicely. Let me see if I'm using I could replace Dropbear with SSHFS, with Secure Shell. And I'm just annoyed that I did it in the first place. And this is, again, the sort of, the role developers have in fucking us over. They really don't like us. And I realize I am a developer, and I don't like you either. And I don't like myself. So, it works. Okay, let me take a quick look to see if my DigitalOcean server... God damn it. I'm pretty sure I'm not running a web server there, but... I might be able to get it off of... Let's see... I have way too many machines. tracks. Some I have aliases set up for machines that no longer even exist. Okay. Alrighty. I'm just going to keep saying words for a while. Alright. I'm going to go ahead and log into another one of my machines here. And this one... Okay. I might be able to pull this off. Okay. This one is basically WordPress.BarryCarter.info, which is my WordPress blog, but it actually hosts some other... and by the way, this is org.info because I fucked things up. But you can also get to other blogs from here, so it is not just... Come on, really? Oh, no, it's random.blog. So you can do this. And there's nothing... I don't think there's anything here now. Yeah, this is just a blank WordPress site. So I should be able to tweak, using cPanel, tweak this to allow another domain. But I'm kind of wondering now if there's an existing domain I can fuck with. That I'm not using. The answer is probably no. Let's see. And it's bad habit to do that anyway, even if I did do it. But wow. So this is a nightmare. We started out trying to find a place we could quickly update files so that Google could test them, so that we could make the page mobile friendly and then copy it over to GitHub pages, which is where the actual code is. So this was our goal, and now we are approximately 20 minutes into this without having any progress. Unfortunately, the other site I have is a shared server, so that doesn't really work well, but I think Emacs will allow me to... okay, I've done this before, but I don't remember how. Let's Google Emacs access remote files. Unfortunately, it might also use SFTP. Remote files. There's a real clever way of doing it. The issue here is the issue is this. I think this obviously has to use some sort of protocol to do this. So let's just see if this. I don't think this is going to work. But anyway. That should be root at, because I'm a terrible person. At this point, it's going to actually ask me. Okay. Yes, I do want to continue connecting. The password is okay. And stand by while I remember what the password is again. This is clearly heading into disaster here. Okay. And unfortunately, if this uses SFTP, that's not going to help us any. Okay. Those five letters. And then those letters. Found remote shell prompt. Okay. Okay. Oh. So it's using SCP, not SFTP. I guess that's good enough. I mean, I don't care. All right. And I don't think Maggie got synced over, which is fine. Let's see if I can do this. It's going to ask me if I want to create the directory. Meta x make directory. Return. Return. Okay. Alrighty. So this is kind of weird because now I have this is mounted from my VM. It's not mounted. I'm accessing it from my VM instead of from my real machine. But now let's see if everything has gone wrong. This is the magic that we want. Also, if I can spell my name right. Ha-ta-da! Okay, is everyone excited? Everyone please be excited. Okay. All right, so after 300 years, we've set this up. So now what we want to do, of course, here is... By the way, it is a little bit slow, because obviously we're going over this... So it's still... It's faster than what we had before, but it's slower than... it would be if I could... I think it's slower than SSHFS. Sounds like a machine saying it now. All right, so we need to add this property now to Google because we need this to be the thing we're going to test to get usability, it's a fucking mess, but... And since we're not mounted, I'm going to have to copy the files over one at a time. I'm not too worried about that part, though. So let's go over here. Coverage, sitemap, speed, mobile usability... add property, and I think here I can go all the way, if you know what I mean. Meaning I can put in the whole domain name because the whole domain is mine. Okay. Copy the text provider, okay. This is really the correct way to do it. I mean, this is really awesome. But let's do this instead. Wait. Okay, this is kind of weird because I don't know if it's going to actually allow me to do this. I mean, technically, the domain is the whole domain, but anyway. Oh, okay. Enter full URL prefix. HTTP. Okay. All right, it is Pomodoro time, and I do want to do it this time back in 2 and 2. And we are back-ish. Okay. So now we'll download this file. Not a problem. Now in theory, I can get this from wherever the hell I keep my downloads. Which I could have sworn was in downloads. But apparently not. So let's go over here, see where the hell this ended up. And there's the downloads. It's not looking good. Whew. It might be because I'm outside of, okay, because this now thinks I'm inside of, yeah, I know it's wrong. Okay. Yeah, I do have to do this from here because I'm not trying to get to a file on Maggie. This is actually was trying to help me. Sons of bitches. Let me make, there's two files here, I think, that, no, actually, this should be fine. This should be fine. So now this is where I can do this, sites, Maggie, can I just write it what it is? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so now let's go see if that verifies. This should be, again, in real time, so this should already be there now. Ta-da! Okay. There's nothing you can do about this, by the way. This looks like it's a checkbox that says you can turn it off. You can't. Okay. So now, unfortunately, because we don't have a mount, we can't do a copy. We have to use Emacs to sort of copy stuff over, which is really ugly, but I don't think there's such a thing as SCP mount. Although now that I said it, I want to see if I can do it. So, SCP Mountain? Okay. Unfortunately, I think this is going to say we need SFTP for this. Yep. Can you do it with SCP? No, see, SCP isn't in there. So I think we're going to have to use SCP in quotation marks. And let's see what this does. Okay, that doesn't actually do what we want. So this keeps saying SCP or SFTP. SCP definitely works on my remote machine. This should be a workable thing. Okay, does HFS have a mount mode that is SCP? Maybe that's the issue. Don't know how the hell I did that, but didn't want to. Okay. Custom port, that's not helpful. Okay, let me see if there's an I'll go ahead and do it from here. There is a optioned SSF in this thing to use SCP. Doesn't appear to be. Okay, it might be under mount options. Reconnect, delay connect. Synchronous writes, debug cache, workaround. Ooh, it sounds like this would be a workaround, but apparently it is not. Okay. So this. This maybe could be the path to SCP. I don't think SCP and SFTP are not the same thing. Unfortunately, I think we're not going to be. I don't think we're going to be able to do this. I think we need. Well, we don't need SFTP as Emacs has proven for us, but. But let's see. So let's really go crazy here. SS. And then we must not have this maybe will give us zero results. So this better have SCP in it. Okay, this is fine. Oh, well, fuck you. Okay. That's not good. I could, of course, do NFS mount, but I'm pretty sure I don't have that set up on the roulette site either. Okay, hang on. Let's do this. Without SFTP. Specifically, people saying I don't have it. SCP, okay. Ooh. Okay, this looks good. SCP. Oh, wow. So SSHFS no longer shows up now. Oh, actually, but that might be okay. Yeah, this is just going down a rabbit hole here. Okay. Okay, fuck it. Let's just go ahead and do this the hard way. So we do have an index.html. Cool. Not the one we want. Index.html2. This is the one with the metaport. Okay, good. Oh, no, that's the one with the wrong metaport. No, this has both the viewport and the Google site verification, which I think we can get rid of because we have verified in some other way. So I think we can just make our head tag blank, do this again. See, I just saved it, totally pointless. So where I want to save it though is I'm gonna regret this. Well, actually, maybe it won't. Yes, overwrite. Yes, proceed anyway. Woohoo! Ooh, 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 ooh. Okay, so now let's go ahead and close some tabs. And now let's go here. Now we can keep this up as a. Okay, good deal. So I will make a note to myself. Remember to copy Maggie files back to GitHub pages, because we're now going to be doing everything on Maggie, but of course that is not live on our, actually vaguely interesting that, I could put everything there. I have to do it one at a time. Actually, can I do that? I think we can do that using just SCP. I probably can do that using rsync, actually, now that I think about it. Alright, give me a second here. I'm going to make all the files that were on in the GitHub pages, put them over there so we have them on Maggie. First of all, I want to make sure that there's not too many of the damn suckers. 124 megabytes, okay. This has the potential of failure written all over it. Okay, cool. It's gonna write the Git directory too, which I didn't really want. So that was a nice bad thing. I'm gonna go and remove it over there, because we don't want that. So please stand by. I was gonna let it copy the git shit over the git shit, and then delete it, but apparently letting it copy the git shit over is gonna take a while. But hopefully not too long, because I'm supposed to have a fast connection through Comcast. And I'll give it about five more. I know you can't see what I'm doing, which is cool. I mean, it's not cool for you, cool for me. Although, to be honest, I probably could have just done that on the VM as well. Okay, this is going to take way too long to do it this way. So, I'm going to do rsync with a minus minus exclude directory. Unfortunately, I don't know how to do that, so that's kind of... Oh, actually, that's not too hard. Minus minus exclude equals... star dot get star, and then I'm going to do it in dry run mode to make sure that it's... Whoa. Okay, I'm going to do that. Okay, we're getting closer to what we want. And I'm doing it in dry run to make sure the git doesn't get carried over. Whoa. That is not what I wanted. Oh. Okay. Please stand by. Okay, that should work. And then after I do this, I will need to delete the git, which will take me a second. Because I don't need to create a git over there. It occurs to me I could have also done a git pull on the remote server. So again, once again, I've probably, because this is all public stuff, I could have just pulled it directly onto the server, which would have taken less time because the server is much faster than my upload connection here to the server. So huge, huge waste of time today, and you're welcome. Okay, come on. There's a lot of crap here. All right. Okay. Okay, alright, so it should all be over there now. So if I reload, I don't even need to do that. So I should now actually be able to see nothing. Oh, fudge, because everything is in pages. Okay. Okay. Be a sec here. So I basically copied everything into one directory level too high, except for the single index.html file, which is correct. So I'm going to fix that over here. I hate my life. Okay. Move everything there, and then move the index file back to the main level. All right, boys and girls, so let's see if this actually works. It's self-contained, so... Shiny. It's OpenStreetMap at a low opacity. Gee, I wonder what the climate looks like here in... you know what? Screw New Mexico. Let's go to Louisiana. Let's look at the climate stuff in Louisiana. It's pretty green. And of course that has a meaning, but that's something for later. Okay, cool. So this is good. We've copied everything over. We are in position to change it. We might need to put a meta name onto everything, which is going to be a flippin' pain in the ass. Okay. Let's see. The other problem here is I usually keep the BC info stuff in Git and then push it using, you know, rsync, but that's taking too long. So, because Jesus Christ, that's ugly. Hang on one sec here. Okay. Okay. Oh. That might not be as bad as I think it is. But I don't want to have to sync each time anyway, so that's still a com an extra command there. So now I need to make another note to myself. Be sure to copy Maggie files back to tilde bcgit bcinfo3 if desired. Because this is just a test directory, I might not care what's in there. But it is something I should be aware of. Okay. With all that out of the way, let's see if we can get the motherfucker to do anything. I say with the. So this is the. And this actually technically should be fine if I just do this. So that's the property I want to inspect. Come on, Google. Oh, this page is not because of an error. Okay. Request indexing. Okay, cool. So we're back in business now, I think. Okay, cool. I apparently am a fucking fuck. Will not change its position in the queue. Okay, basically, don't do that. Okay. So. Hope this won't. Okay, shit. So this might be worse than we thought it was. Oh, good, 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 good. Okay. URL can be indexed, but. Oh, son of a bitch. Certain condition. Where are these conditions? Okay. All right. We have a Pomodoro time. I'll be back in 2 minutes and 2 seconds. And we are back, pretty much. Okay. So this is actually not that helpful. Okay, so this might just be telling me. I have no idea what the hell it's telling me. Let's fix these problems we sort of know about. What do you mean viewport not set? I definitely have one. Ooh. What the hell is that? What the hell is that? Okay, bad shit's going on. there's a way to identify the character under the cursor. It might be describe character. Well, this one. Okay. So according to this, the issue here is before there's a U and IND before the viewport. Oh, maybe it's trying to do code highlighting there. Okay. I don't know how to make this, like, meta viewport tag. So meta name equals viewport. This, the only, that's a single quote. So hang on. Let me make these all double quotes. Maybe that's the issue here. Oh. Okay. So regular, oh, you know what? These might be like funky quotes. I don't know. Because I cut and pasted. Maybe that's the reason something weird happened. I cut and pasted from another site, which apparently does not think of these as the correct tags. Okay. So now, Mr. Google, can you, all of these problems might be fixed. Okay. Well, same problems, but let's see if the viewport part of it is solved. Ooh. Okay, that we can probably fix. So apparently there's an issue report for this. Well, that doesn't really help us. Okay. And I tell you, back in the day, this really sucks actually, because back in the day, list is a perfectly valid HTML tag. So there's no reason this shouldn't work. Okay. Well, let's go ahead and go over to piece of shit. Okay. HTML list element. Elements too close. Let's see how we can fix that. Okay. Yeah, it's already cost me an eye trying to fix it. This is okay. So this is HTML list element and elements too close together. I could put that in there as well. Okay, motherfucker. 5 results. Actually, maybe I should say HTML list element. List tag? Well, that's an element, but it's also a tag. Wow, none. Okay, let's say tag. And this really sucks. Basically, they've broken HTML. Google has broken HTML. Gosh, I'm smart. Okay. I mean, the obvious way to do this is basically to put a paragraph tag between these suckers and weep for the future of mankind. So let's see if that helps over here. Again, this is such bullshit. I hate Google for breaking HTML. Or I guess it's... Well, never mind. Let's just see what this does. Ta-da! Get selected as canonical. We don't actually care about that part because we are, we're not going to put it on this URL. This is our testing URL. Okay. That's one. So what the hell was the point of all... Yes, the point of all this was to see if we can get Google to index data instead of just indexing... So basically, we haven't even gotten to the point yet. Instead of just indexing, HTML pages. So I'm kind of curious to see if it can index the other stuff I have in my collection. And the answer might be no, because we might need to have this piece of shit meta name viewport. And since there's no server side on GitHub pages, I can't even just do an include there. So major suckiness there too, but that's an issue for the future. So now, the whole point of what we're trying to do, there's no way we're going to get it to index, something really, really huge. So I did remove that really, really huge thing from data. So let's see what we can get it to index. So this is where it gets kind of bizarre. Okay, let's just look for size limit here, basically. We're going to break this up a little bit, but Google indexing page size limit. There is such a thing. Wow. Okay. So 520k, but let's be, sort of obnoxious here. Let's just get a really big file. Oh, well, I can't do that because we're inside of something. But let's just look at a really big file that we have, which is... I don't think this is going to be big enough. Yeah, it's not. This thing. And I don't think there's a way to say show me the first million characters or something. But let's see how much the first 10,000 lines take up. 696k. So if what we're talking about is correct, this Google will not be able to index the whole thing here. But if it can, this actually doesn't matter because I'm going to have to put it somewhere anyway. Okay. And so now, did I just, what did I call it? Test.txt, of course. Anything to be inconsistent. Okay, so now, this may not be the, okay. Let's just call it test.txt. Okay. No. Okay. Why do you need my password again? All right, screw this. Yes, we're going to let it die. This could get so ugly so fast. Okay. All right, so what the hell? So clearly, you can write to this. I mean, I don't have. Oh, so maybe what I can do is this. I can actually load in test.txt. Ha-ha! Screw you. And then I can insert into it the local test.txt. I am so clever. What the hell? You don't need one. We're fine. All right, let me see if that made it. I don't think that made it over, but let's see. Yep, that didn't make it over. So I don't know why the hell it needs my password all of a sudden. But okay. Apparently it does. If this keeps happening, though, this is going to be an issue. Happy? Okay. So now if we load it here, good deal. And now, Mr. Google, we would like you to index it or tell us that you cannot index it because it is too big. Dun 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 dun. That's the Tiny Toons theme. Okay, it's just the live URL. And now the key here will be to make sure we get the whole thing. And if we don't, now that I think about it, of course, a really long page isn't going to be mobile friendly anyway. So we're in hard sucky mode here. But we might learn something. Okay. Now it is okay. Oh! Coolio. Okay. What's view tested page? I didn't know I had all that HTML in there. That's kind of weird. All right, so let's see if it goes all the way down to the end. Da, 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 da. Well, let's look for this number, I guess. But I mean, this is not really that bad. Yeah, looks like it did it. Looks like we made it, baby. So now, of course, we have to break it again. Because that is how we do things. Okay, so we probably should make a note here. Okay. So now, because we like test, we're going to go to 50,000 now. And, okay. And now I'm going to. Do this. So this is going to take a little. Well, this won't take time, but once we save. Ooh. Yo mama? Right. Because it is, of course, this that I'm trying to insert. Okay. Now this is going to take a few seconds to save. Okay. This is bad. I should not be repeatedly prompted for a password. The only thing I'm thinking is, let me try saving it to. Wait, what the hell? Let me try saving it to pages test.txt. Maybe that won't prompt me. Nope, don't like this. Okay. Not cool. Not cool at all. All right. And so I'm gonna have to fix this. or just memorize my password like I did. Or find another machine to do this on. Or there's like a billion options here. Okay. Hopefully, I think the password's correct. It's just trying to copy over this 50,000 line file. So that'll take a little while in. Whew, okay. So this is pages.txt, so we're going to be a little bit careful here. And we also have to be careful in the sense that we're sucking up a lot of our own data here. Well, not that much, but I mean, we're also basically, pulling a lot of crappers. This is 3.4 megabytes. At some point, I might want to not go as far as that. So let's, okay. So let's do this. Inspect away, Mr. Google. And it's going to say not available because you haven't, because it actually doesn't show up anywhere. I don't want to index this, so I just want to test it. So we are testing a live URL, and when you are testing a live URL, be sure to be grounded because otherwise you could get a live URL shock because, it could be like, oh man, I don't remember the name of that picture that everybody, a Tub Girl, could be Tub Girl, or something. So that is a standard warning from the people who confuse electricity with networking. Okay. Hit me with some lovin', tell me it's too big, Google. It's too big, you can't take it, huh? It's too big for you, Google. Huh. I'll make it fit. That was, of course, the comparing URLs to sexual intercourse and penis size. So that's a fun thing we did too. Okay, it is Pomodoro time, and I will do it. And hopefully, by the time I'm back, this will be done. Back in 2 and 2. Okay, we are almost back, and we are now back. Okay, so it looks like this is happy with this. Let's see how what you think. Okay, let's see how far you go down here. And then I mess something up, which you can't see, but I can. Bugs me. Okay. Well. Mr. Google's being very interesting today. Wow. Okay. Take a note of that. Okay. Well, let's see you index 200,000 lines. Hopefully, I have that many lines. Think I do, actually. Let's make sure, though. Okay, yeah. All right, bitch. Nope, I don't want to find it. I want to include it. This will take a few seconds. Yeah. That was some pretty good whining. God damn it. All right. we're going to fix that in just a minute here. Or I'm just going to end up memorizing my password. But actually, I think we need to fix that. And this is going to take a while to get copied. Not that much time, but it is going to take a while to get copied over. Because it is pretty big. Pretty, pretty big. As Larry David would probably not say, because I do not think he deals with large files. But then again, I don't know. Okay. Yeah, so this is... I guess I'll do some soul music while we're waiting. I don't know any soul music, it turns out, so we will not be doing that. Instead, we will be gleefully anticipating what will happen once this file gets copied over. And let's also make some plans for not having to do this. SCP is not doing a great job here. So what I think I'll do is I'll end up modifying the files locally, going to my other machine and syncing them over, and hoping that because we're only syncing over a fairly small amount of crap, it's not going to take too long. I mean, it'll still take some time because these are large files, but maybe not as much time as it's taking right now. But we will give this another 1 minute. We'll give this until 16:46, I think, on the clock on the top left, which is this guy. So in about another minute and 9 seconds. And if this doesn't work, we will brutally kill off the SCP process and use another inefficient process to do this. Okay, so it is now... I think that was... got it, right? Yeah, it did. All right, let's rock and roll. Now, loading this is going to take a freaking... There we go. So I'm at the end of the page. It's going to really... chunking up a bit here. Okay, so I'm just out of curiosity, I wonder how this goes all the way into, well, not that far forward, but this is a pretty chunky page. I wonder if we can get some page info. I don't think that, oh yeah, 13 million bytes. All right. Okay, Mr. Google smartass. Although at some point, I don't want to make pages this big. I would like it retested, please. Thank you. I guess if I could, I'd like the whole set, the whole file. Actually, I can't even upload a file that big to GitHub. So really, to GitHub pages. I can if it's compressed, but not if it's uncompressed. Although, the question now is, can Google index compressed pages? It should be able to, but no one really knows. Well, that's not true. People probably do. So this is Google's time. Google can test this. If this works, let's go ahead and try to see if it can do a bzip a file and get that and presumably unbzip it on the fly. And if so, oh yes, awesome. Something did go wrong. And because something went wrong, I don't think this data is probably not correct anymore. This is the tested page from the last time it was viewed. And it is. Okay. So something went wrong. This is kind of good, actually. And we'll give it another shot, but I think we have broken the limit. So there's still an open question as to whether or not it can do bzip two files. So we'll try that as well. But clearly there is a size limit here. We're not going to try to find it exactly. But we know it's going to be between, if this fails again, we know it's going to be between 50,000 and 250,000. there wasn't a file size limit, we would try to push it as hard as we could and just get it all indexed in one big go. But since there is, let's see if we can be somewhat clever about how we get this data indexed, because there's not a limit of how much data you can put. Well, there is, but it's a pretty big limit on how much data you can put into GitHub pages, but the size of the file is limited. I'm going to take 1 second out here to answer somebody who is not with us. I mean, he's live, obviously. Okay. Okay. So someone who wants to help, I've told them that I will help them later, or they have the option to come on. Okay, good. So this is good. So we want, I think that is exactly, tells us what we need to know. Doing 200,000 line test. I'll put a comma there for readability. At 13 million bytes, which I won't put a comma on, failed. Okay, solid. Now we're going to do the whole bzip2 crap. I don't know why I did that, because there's nothing here. Now the question is, oh brother, in theory, this is not going to work in reality. I can do this, and this brings it down to about 2 million bytes, and then I could do test.text.bz2 here. That's not what I wanted. I might have to call it something else. Wow. Okay. I think it's unhappy because Emacs assumes that it's a bzip2 file, which it's not. I'm going to go over on the server directly and fuck with things. So let me go ahead and make a copy of pages. So I'm going to copy test.txt to test2.txt and then bzip it. Okay. Now this shouldn't work. If I go to test2.txt here, this shouldn't work because I don't have automatic BD zipping, but this should fuck me over. That is not what I wanted. Okay, so this is technically correct, but not what I wanted. And let's see if Google does a better job of indexing it, although I don't think it will. Because if I can't index, I mean, if regular browsers don't show it correctly, it's not going to work. But not because of an error. Test live URL, this is going to fuck it over hard. Hopefully it'll be clever if it can figure out that this is a bzip compressed file, which is why it can't be indexed. Or I mean, maybe it'll try to index it as a by unzipping it. We will find out shortly as we chat with Google. Dun da da da. We're testing live URLs, and I do want to remind everyone that no URLs were harmed in the processing of this stream. We did harm some URLs prior to the stream, and after the stream we do plan to harm some additional URLs, but during the stream itself we are being conscientious and not, we're using non-invasive testing of URLs. So I'm getting pretty bored here with this. Let's give it a few more minutes. Yeah, something went wrong. Okay. And that's probably not a big deal, because at this point we've kind of decided that Google's just not going to index large files, and bzip compressing them, I don't think, is going to really do anything. Okay, solid. So now, what do we do next? We are in BC. So now we can actually sort of go back to the data pages. And so the question is, how are we going to think what's interesting here is I don't even have to do, okay. So the question is, how are we going to break this up so that it's not too many lines, and at the same time, and we probably can get rid of these two columns here because they just provide data that's not really necessary. But the question is basically, split this up in a clever way so that Google will index it? And that's that is an actual question. I don't know the answer. And I'm thinking we might be able to use like 100-year chunks, but 100-year chunks we could do. Can we do 1,000-year chunks? And this is clearly not the way to find out, obviously, but let's see. Okay. So that would be going from 13201 to 12201, although technically we will probably break it up into what we consider to be 1,000-year chunks. Okay, and that is line 209,147, and I think our tests prove that we're not getting anywhere near that in Google. So that's not going to work. So if we break it down by century, how about if we break it down? Well, okay. I mean, we kind of now know that. We would expect that a century would be a tenth of what that was, so about 20,000 lines. Let's go ahead and confirm that. Okay. Something went wrong there. Okay. 20,000 lines. Okay. Which would fit. So if we broke it down to a 500 years, that's 100,000 lines. Let's go ahead and write this down in... Do I have my note command working? I do not. Each century is about 20,000 lines. And we know from our lovely 50,000 lines is fine. 200,000 lines is not fine, so we can't do 1,000 years. We can probably do 500 years, we don't know if we can do. 250 years, we know we can do. But that's sort of an unusual time to 250 years. We know we can do, but I guess the other question is we kind of want people to be able to look at these pages too. We don't necessarily want to go all crazy with, by being overly pedantic. We don't want to necessarily hit the Google limits for indexing. We want to make the page viewable as well. Since we cannot get Google to index large amounts of data without doing that. So maybe, we could say maybe a century per page, which has some other good points to it. And let's see, what do we want to do here? Now, obviously, we'll want an index, we want to point to this from the index. We'll want to create a little index page, that points to the various centuries. And we might even want to say, this is the 19th and the 20th and the 21st century are extra important. We get those. Now, the question is, what's the easiest way to get this split up by century? And obviously, we're going to put 13,200 into the same century as 13,100. Now we could write a Perl script to do this. I'm trying to see if we can do it more cleverly than that. Using a Perl one-liner. And the answer to that is we might be able to, but it would take longer than actually writing a Perl script to do this. So I think we are good. All right. Let's Perl it up, man. So... I think we need to kill this buffer. let me do a list buffers here. And anything that is there, don't need those. Okay. And I want to go ahead. I there's probably going to be an SCP process going on here. Actually, let's see what our processes are. Motherfucker. And I'm looking for anything that's trying to connect now remotely. These look fine. Damn, I'm running a lot of processes I probably don't need. I should probably turn them off. Let's see. So one other way to do this, let's see if Emacs has spawned any processes. Because it would be an Emacs spawn that we... Well, there should be an Emacs. Okay. Well, if Emacs has spawned processes, let's make sure they're not taking up too much. Yeah. So whatever the hell's going on here, the load average is zero. So it's whatever it is, it's not too bad. Okay, so let's go ahead and write up our Perl script now. BC git astro. Let's see. Do I want to say parse? Parse horizons, parse Jovian lunar eclipses. I guess we'd say parse houses. Yeah, that's probably okay. Okay. Perl. Always require my library. And then this is one file I really don't want to pull in all at once. It is really big. Okay, Pomodoro time, back in 2 and 2. And now we're back. Okay, one thing I tried to do earlier is to, for flexibility, I tried to create, some hash names in Perl that let you use my libraries even if you decide to put my git somewhere else. However, it doesn't actually work because every time I update the library, you will be forced to see, what the hell? There we go. You'll basically get Git Home will be reset. So I really need to fix that. I'm not going to, but I need to. Okay. So right now we're just going to say, we want to make sure we can actually read this file. All this good stuff. I don't know if this is going to work. The problem is, when I write files, they're not by default, Jesus fucking Christ, they're not by default executable. So I do have to do this magic. Let's take a look. Yeah, we're working. And we can also probably just chomp that down a little bit. And I know what you're thinking is, well, no, maybe I don't know what you're thinking. Yeah, there we go. All right, so now, first of all, we don't really need these last two fields, and I'm okay with that. What's interesting here, I think, is the way I've got this set up. It's always going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 fields, and then 8 and 9. In other words, the number of fields is constant because they either say prograde or retrograde. There's a temptation to proper case all this shit, but I probably won't do that. Okay, so the big number here is, of course, this one here and this one here, BCE and the actual date. Okay. Now, so the clever bit here comes in, so let's go ahead and do a mod 100 of this. Am I going to regret that? I probably will. Okay. So let's go ahead, I don't want to ask this, I do want to do this. Okay, so the problem I'm going to worry about is if when we go to CE, is there there probably won't be a space there. So unless there are one, you know, I shouldn't say not spaces. I guess I could say that. Followed by a space. Followed by a bunch of digits. That's the only part I really need. Decide what file it goes in. And this is one of those things that is either always going to fail or always going to, and then do this, but anyway. And so this is again just to make sure that we're actually getting the things I want, and if we're not, it's going to be a simple fix, I'm hoping. No! Okay, so the problem here is. It actually has to be, we want all of them at the beginning of the line. Okay, that's fine. So this is start of line. Oh, I'm sorry. We want to capture it with every character in there. Then the space. So this is BCE, okay. We might need to make a special case for 13201, I can deal with that. Okay, so then we want to take basically I'm declaring this variable each time in this loop, but I guess that's supposed to be okay. So the number we want is basically the second in theory, I could have just used $ and $2 directly in an equation, but that's really bad. We should really do this. So here we can just use ear now. If era equals BCE, ear times equals minus 1. So we negate the ear if we're in BCE. There's going to be a very interesting situation. Well, it's not that interesting. that occurs at BCE 1. It's probably not the best way to find it, but here we go. Actually, do we have multiple spaces? Ooh, hang on. Oh, there we are. So it is only one space, but I will be careful and allow for multiple spaces if necessary. Because there's no read if they decide to do it that way. So the interesting situation here is the year that follows 1 BCE should be 1 CE. Which it is. So there's no zero year is the point. Which is fine. That's the way it's supposed to be. Okay. Well, I won't say. So we want to put it in the file that's essentially... I'm going to say FNAME. 100. FNAME is... And there's going to be a glitch here, but I'm aware of it. All right, so let's see, roughly speaking, what kind of file name we would want to put it in. And of course, when I say mod 100, I meant div 100. Now, 99.9% sure this is going to give me non-integer division. The few times you actually want it, it's not going to work. And there we go. That is absolutely correct. And I guess we're going to round. I guess it doesn't really matter. Doesn't really matter how we round. So we're not going to round, actually. We need to take either the ceiling or the floor. So let's do that. A rare case of where... cool. Minus 133. Okay. And I guess it's more helpful if we also say what the actual year is. Otherwise, we don't know what the hell we're doing. Okay, so for the only special case... So minus 132. And I guess to make life easier, we actually want to think of this as... Do I care? Maybe I don't, actually. And in theory, I hate ignoring values, but in theory we can ignore the values where this is like, 13201. Or I guess we could actually just change it there. Okay. So let's take a little bit more of a look at that. Let's just see what happens when we get to like 2018. Okay, so the file name is 20 for what's technically the 21st century, but no one does that. Okay. All right. So now, what do we actually do with all this information, and what's the plan here? The plan here is we're going to have a file called the cur file, which is what we're writing to right now. And right now we're just going to write to temp or something to make things easier. If cur file is an fname are the same thing, then we just okay. And we also need okay. Yikes. Okay. Let's see. We also basically need to chop off the other two. The last two things, which are not, ephemeris time is actually somewhat useful, but I don't think we really want it. Okay, so we can basically say we can take the last, so any number of spaces followed by any number of non-spaces followed by any number non-spaces $ dun dun. And semicolon debug chomped, and let's see if what that does. That should just get rid of the last two fields, but it doesn't. That's kind of cool. space. The only thing I'm wondering about is this is there's like extra spaces there. So that would be this. Oh, interesting. Okay. Not cool. So what if we just do this? Cut off the last... Oh, I know what's wrong. I don't think I can undo that, though. Okay. Sorry, it's the last bunch of space... any number of spaces followed by the second to last word, followed by any number of spaces, followed by the last word, followed by potentially any spaces. But not necessarily. Okay, so this... There we go. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And it's a little bit of a check. Little bit of a check. We want to make sure that after we've chomped it, it ends in prograde or retrograde. So let's just see if that... yep, I don't think... Gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous. Okay. So now what we're going to do is, if the current file and the file name disagree, we're going to... This looks strange because we don't have necessarily have B open, but that's okay. Let's say temp. Let's say... so the curl file... So then we go ahead and set curl file to the F name. Open B. And this is actually, sorry. If the current file is equal to the file name, we just print to the existing open file handle this, and then we proceed. We don't need to do anything else. So this case is now if it's not equal. So if this is going on, what do we need to do? This is, we've got to be careful here because we don't want to lose anything. We don't want to lose necessarily the first event of each century. So we close B, we set this, we open, we reopen B, this time to be the what is now the cur file, and we'll call it .text. I want to be able to recognize it if we need to, and then I want to print B this line, and I think that is it. And so if this works, every time we have a change in the file name, this will update. So let's run this. At this point, by the way, there should be almost no output. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. I'm just counting randomly. We're not going to let it finish, but let's see what we have here. I probably meant to say, oh, cool. Thanks to my lovely chomping. Obviously, we're gonna name this more nicely, but for right now. But thanks to my lovely chomping, we have lost the important, all-important new line. I suck. Hopefully this won't break my other kind of chomping. This unfortunately because I did it for a different amount of time. We need to look at one of the ones that are this one or two. Yeah, unfortunately, I think between this now does that, so... Oy vey. I wonder if doing after this, I can just replace that with a... This is some really ugly code there. Okay. probably do want a little bit of debugging here, but let's see what this does. These are fairly chunky files, but they're not too big. Okay. Gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Okay. Wait. Hmm. 20,000 lines. And we are... I could just jump to... Oh, let's do that, in fact. But we want to make sure it ends in the right way. And I want it to end at 9,900 because most people fuck. Okay. Because most people would consider 9,900... Well, negative 99... it's really not correct, but... All right, hang on. Let's see. The problem might come in when we have the year 2000. So let's see what this does. This does floor of year divided by, so 2000 will be the year, it will be 20. And 2099, okay, that's actually okay. The only issue here is going to be actually, that might have been literally correct. So we want to begin at 10,000 and end at 9901 because the 9990 would actually belong in negative 99. So it's doing exactly what we want. Okay? Pomodoro, back in 2 and 2. And we are almost back. And we're back. Okay. So this looks pretty good. This helps us to create the files that we need. We probably want to give them slightly better names. I mean, these were test names, obviously. So what we're going to do here... I'm going to be a little bit careful here. So the ending year is going to be... So... Okay. And obviously the F name is not going to be quite this simple. So this is going to be actually the start year, and the end year is going to be the start year, not plus 100, but plus 99, because if you count from 0 to 99, that's actually 100 numbers. That's our basic fence post condition. So now what we want to do is something like negative 10,000 to negative... 9,900. That looks so hideous, though. We don't really want to do that. So this is let's see. We want to get rid of the negative sign and replace it with something like BCE. But let's see if we can be, well, let's not be too clever about that. And I think thanks to the, so if S here is less than 0, F named is equal to, oh, I need to declare this because I'm putting it in an if statement. I can't declare it inside of the if. So I could do this. F name is equal to B, okay, so hang on. Okay. If it's less than 0, we're going to make it its absolute value. Then the F name will be BCE. I guess we need to make the E here its absolute value. This is not great programming here. Else, otherwise it's easy. Then we can just, well, actually, hang on, let's see. I want to do this. Else, current era to current era. Okay. Now, okay. I want to be able to test this without having to necessarily write to files, but that might actually be okay. Because we do want some debugging out of this whole thing. So let's do this. So basically, if we're getting to a new file name, we'll say new file name is fname. Okay, so let's see what this does. Let's see, be careful here. Oh. Temp. Now we should just be able to say fname here. And at some point we're going to put it in the right directory. But that's comes later. Okay, so let's do this, debug, and hopefully we can watch it. Yeah, there's something wrong there. Okay, not cool. And I know it's wrong. Because I think our S here we divided, but yeah, we did. Okay, so we want to round it to the. So this is what we want. We want to divide it by 100, take the floor, multiply it by 100. So, someone I'm going to need to do a lot of deleting in. Okay. All right, hang on. I think the very first one is correct, but this is technically correct because there's only one ear in this. So that's probably not great. So let's go ahead and for that special ear. So, yeah. Special case, and there might be two of them. But let's see, if S ear, and this is going to be negative 130, oh no, actually negative 13,300. Then we just pretend it's the next one. Okay. Now to get this to work correctly, we do have to remove all these temp files that I've been creating all over the freaking place. I don't think I created any with CE, but I know I created some with foo.txt. Okay. And this is going to be probably... I want to see the foo files before I... yeah, okay. So they look fine. Okay, so now what we can do here is... This is not a clever way of doing it, but you can basically force it to say yes to everything. And let's see if our temp looks okay now. It does not. Oh, lovely. Because we have a minus sign here at the beginning, remove thinks of this as an option. You could fix that by saying dash dash, which means end of options. Okay, so hopefully that worked. Wow. Okay. So I should now. Oh, I'm sorry. I meant to say YY, meaning repeat the letter Y constantly. So now, that didn't work. Maybe I can just say Y. And of course I can do this with a hard remove if I have to. Why is it doesn't like that? One possibility is that it's not actually removing these things as I tell it to, but I'm hoping that's not the truth. That's not the case. Oh, okay. Don't know why that didn't work, but okay. And while we're at it, we might as well get rid of the test thing that we had. And so now what do we have there? Mozilla user 0 is probably okay. I don't know what the hell those other things are. They look kind of scary, but we'll leave them there. I get the feeling this is a bad idea. Oh, whoa, that's shiny. Okay. Don't know what the hell that was. Okay. So now we've gotten rid of all that crap in temp. I think I like these file names enough that we can actually write them directly now to data. We can actually go ahead and... I gotta be careful here because this is a different... This is GitHub Pages. This is not... And actually, I want to go... Okay, so... We're here in BC Git Pages Data... But there's lots of different types of data. So here we want to call this houses. And then this is where we want to put this, in this hideous directory here in houses. We will look at it before we push it to GitHub Pages. And there's something else we need to do that we're going to look at in just a sec here too. All right. So if this works, good things will happen. There we are. Yeah, I did want to print the new file name. Okay. Now, the only possible problem here is we're going to get into a problem when we hit the year 13,201 in the forward direction. So, tra-la-la-la-la-la-la. Hopefully this is correct. Now, obviously, if I were doing, you know, if I were being clever, I wouldn't be printing out all these results, you know, unless with the possibility that some would be wrong. I would have probably skipped over a few of them or something. And I think I'm going to allow CE0 to CE99, even though there is no CE0. And there we... Oh! Right. Because it's 15,000 years ahead, it's going to be... Okay. So let's see what this is. Nice! So the latest one we have is 17.1... And that one is 19,000 lines. So this is actually okay. It ends at 17, and we over-advertise, but I'm okay with that. Now, all of them... Okay, so this is the one that does not look to be the right size. And I probably don't care. It might be... is it re-included? No. We can just hear it. Screw the year 13,000. Screw this. Okay. Now, one way to check for the that things are working is let's do a... Let's take a look at files that are, you know, the size of the various files. And I, one, two, three, did I mean five? I meant five. Okay. So these are all pretty much the same size, which is good. This, I think, is smaller because it actually doesn't have all the years in it. This is smaller because it's technically missing 1 year because there is no CE0. But in general, this is a very good looking, I like this, this looks good. Now the only thing we need is for this is an index page. And most of our index page is going to just be a list of eras basically. It's going to basically say from this year to this year. So basically every time we have a new file name, we're going to want to print basically something that says, you know, in a list element with a paragraph after it to make Google happy. We're gonna do this here, and I'm gonna be careful here. Now we have sort of a tiny little problem. I don't want to recreate all these files, so I think they're looking pretty good right now, actually. Let's see what it is for, you know, where we are. Right here. So, I have no idea if this is correct or not. And these are astrological houses, so we do need to make a note of that as well. But let's see. Okay, so we'll have an index page that has some garbage in it, but the main part of it is going to be, yeah, we need to convert these to without rerunning the program, and I think we can do that actually because we can just do. Okay, and this is where we actually want to be a little bit careful. We do want to not lose what we're doing here. So we're going to do something that's very, very horrible. And that is, we're going to put in this directory something called, I don't remember if I call it what I call it. Hang on one sec. See, it's one of two things. But I don't remember which one. It's one-liners. Okay. All right. And the reason we don't really want this here is because we don't want this really pushed to our website. It's not harmful, but it's just kind of useless. So what we want to do here is we want to take these. Substitute all dashes with spaces. Substitute B. Okay, hang on. Now, let's not be too clever. We want to substitute BCE with BCE, capitalized, basically. In fact, we might just be able to say to upper. Or even, let's see. Don't know if this is going to work, but that's okay. So now we can go over here and, we could actually have done this in Emacs, too. We can say to shell, or we should just be able to say one-liners, to shell run me. And I meant, of course, this. Undefined, is it two upper? Okay, UC first, that UC, not upper. You play with too many languages at once, that's what happens. So let's see if these would make reasonable looking titles. Well, clearly we don't want the text there. And I think we have one too many spaces in here somewhere. So we can fix both of those problems pretty easily. We can say get rid of the text. By the way, this should be a hard, but it doesn't really matter. Ignore case, because we're not uppercasing yet. And if we have more than one space, always substitute it down to one space. So now let's see if these look any good. The two should probably be lowercase. And let's see. Now the other thing we could do here, which we're not doing, is we could, and you know what, I actually think, now the more I think about this, I think I want to make this a little bit cleaner here. We could in each file, each individual file, put like a header that says, you know, this file came from blah, 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 blah. But we're not going to do that. Well, we could if we wanted to. Actually, that might not be a bad idea. That will give us a little bit of branding. And we could put the lines in as like a, you know, with, that's not a bad idea at all. And put my name in there. Because crap like this tends to get all over the place. Oh, there's this temptation now. All right, Pomodoro, back in 2-2. And we're almost back. And we're back. Okay. So let's actually add a little bit of branding to this. Ooh, brother. Okay. We'll use a here document for this. By the way, the word mark doesn't have to be mark. It could be anything. In fact, just to show you that it doesn't have to be mark, and then I want to make sure that I didn't screw that up, so I'm going to do a debug header here, and then die testing. Okay. And I probably need to, but anyway. Okay. And could actually say for each file, this file lists the conjunct, you know, the planetary astrological changes for these years. But maybe I'll be less specific and just say this is one of many files that does what you want. This file lists this file is one of many that, not consecutively, not conjunctively, that together list all. Do I have a readme on this bitch? I think I do. I think I do have a readme on this. I don't have a readme on the houses, but I might have one here. I don't. Wow. Okay. Okay, let me go ahead and go over here. I might be in the wrong. Nope. Okay, well, there's a code here that does this. Ooh. That is not correct. Because BC Constell does something else completely. So where the hell? Oh, BC Zodiac is probably it. Something very similar to that. Yeah. Okay. Now I want the git location of this. I've written a program that gives me that, and it is that. Okay. So let's go groovy here, and I just wanted to get that URL in there. That together list all astrological, not astronomical, constellation changes for, I don't know, I want to put my contact info in there. I already have the GitHub. And I want also the general one here. So we want to also say, in general, you can also look at this. And I think maybe, even though it's mentioned in this file, I want to put in this reference to Stack Exchange. Okay. That together list. Now what I should do is something, say, Lena, if you want to see the index of all of them, go here. But the problem is if I might take this off of GitHub pages, and I don't necessarily want to hard code GitHub pages in there. So we're going to leave it ambiguous as to where you could find the rest of these files that I claim exist. For Mercury, Venus, I think it's Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, and the Sun and Moon. I don't think I put Uranus in there. I said Uranus. It's funny. All right, and there's a way to check this real quick. So, 0, 1, 2, 3, so. This is the worst possible way to check this, but it does work. Let's make sure this is what we want. It does, okay. Sort minus U, and I'm sure it's gonna just be the, really, it should be in BC Zodiac somewhere that I'm only doing it for these. But we'll wait this out, I guess. I mean, technically, even Uranus would have a house change within the first, you know, 10 billion lines or whatever. I don't have to go through the whole file. Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Moon, Sun. Yep, that's what I thought. Let's just be really spiffy here and do this. What else do I want to say? Oh, yeah. Actually, I don't really know if I want to list. I don't want to list. Well, I guess I kind of do want to list this because. Well, I'm going to look at it real quick, but I think this actually tells more about this. And we will have. Now you can't see there's too little spacing, even though this makes no sense whatsoever in that context. There's sort of a open question in mind. This is the part of the URL that actually counts. The rest of it is just syntactic sugar. But I'm curious as to whether or not. Okay. Oh, good. This actually gives a lot of good information about it, so yeah, we do want that there. So the question I'm having is, can we just say. Can we just, like, cut this off here? And it'll fill it in for us? This just looks so freaking cool. I wonder if that's an effect on how it displays. I don't think it does. I think this is just syntactic sugar that'll fill it in by itself. So yeah, there we go. Okay, one moment. Oh, shit. I was looking at somebody's non-answer. So this actually goes through and gives a hell of a lot more information. And I'm sort of looking at it myself and thinking, what the hell did I do? But I did it. Okay. So what we can do now is we can make this the header. Let's make sure this part of it's working. And this also justifies rerunning this, which is kind of my real goal. Okay. And the reason I want to rerun it is because I want to come up with better names for the list thing that I'm going to be doing. Let's see. Okay, so this is where we get the new file name. Close B, open B, print B header, then print B bullshit, the line that we need. And I guess. Yeah, there's no case where we skip over a line, I don't think. So we always print something, so we never lose a line in doing this, which would be really bad. Because that's one of those small errors that's like fucking impossible to debug. Okay. And honestly. Oh man. Now this number's not going to add up to the total number because we got rid of a few of them from so I actually have no idea how the hell this is going to reconcile this. Yeah, okay, actually I do have an idea. So I'm assuming if the error occurs it's consistent. So what I need to do now is make sure the actual first event in 800 is this event. Actually, make sure the first 10 events are these, and if they are, God, I wish I put a minus I in there. I think that's implicit, though. God damn it, no, it's not. Okay, and I probably should have meant to say dash. Okay, and I probably meant to say. I'll just keep doing this forever. begins with a with you know the beginning of the line has the CE in it. Okay, and I don't need to go to the rest of the file. All right, that's looking pretty good. Now we want to make sure that it, we're not chopping one off at the end. So we're going to say 899 to tail. Dun 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 dun. I need to find another song to hum. Okay, this is looking good, and of course we don't want the garbage at the end. Looking good, looking good. Okay, so we're getting everything in there. Print B header, print B dollar sign. And now the we can now try to cruft up the what's going to be the list text, list item, let's call it. Let's be clever and camel case like grown-ups do. The list item is going to say astrological. This is redundant, but you know. Astrological signs for S-ear through actually let's see. Oh crap. Yeah, the problem here is that I'm actually adding a little bit to FName here. Okay, I think I can handle this. This clearly did not work, by the way. This, whatever the hell I did here did not do anything, but I don't care. Okay, and then here we can set era. Equals BCE for printing. Or you know what? Let's just say BC. I'm going to be terrible and actually support religious naming schemes here. And I'm not sure we need AD. We might just leave that one blank. But anyway, astrological signs for start year era through E year era. And maybe I could turn this into a colon, because I don't like... And since this is a list, I'm not even sure we want to say astrological. You know what? This might be fine. Alrighty. See what it looks like while we recreate it all. With now with more special headers, which gives us an excuse. Oh yeah, because I forgot to remove the stupid testing. I'm a fucking moron. Okay. Well, that's not even correct now. Well, hang on. This one's not correct, but the rest of them are. So I can. This one I don't care about. That one's just weird. Oh, because it. Okay, that's because I did that stupid special case. So actually, let me get rid of that special case. Although, we're just going to delete that. Okay, I think we don't need even, we can just say two. And I'm tempted to, like, omit it for AD, because it's sort of a known thing for AD. Well, let's see, 13... Now, do I put, like... See, now I'm crufting, which is bad. Do I put a dot in B, dot C? Do I put a space... Do I need the space there? All right, so screw this. We're just going to run it. No, actually, we're not. Hang on. We need to do a little bit better than that. Okay. So now, we're going to actually print these out, because I need to keep them. List list item, end list item. We want it, the new line doesn't actually do anything, but it keeps the code looking nice. So now we want to do this t index. Obviously, we're going to fix index.html here in just a minute. And these are real prints, right? Yes, they are. The only problem is it might be printing to the currently open handle instead of the std out. I don't know what the process is there. So now I'm worried. Well, let's see if it printed into here. See what these look like. All right, I guess I will give it one more pound so it can clear the... oh, wow. Thanks to Perl's interpretation of the at sign, I have to do... If I didn't do that, it would look really weird. And we will give it one more line. Okay. Now let's see if at the very end it printed the garbage. Okay. So why am I not getting this print to std out? Print. Std out? I mean. All right, there we go. Okay, well. Pomodoro, back in 2 and 2. And we're almost back. And now we're back. Okay. No chat today? I still give a rat's ass. Okay, so this should... I don't want to cruft too much, so let's go ahead and do this. Okay. And I guess the T kind of... background here. Do I have T piped? No, I don't. Okay. So I guess the T sort of it buffers the input, which is why we're not seeing it right away. But that's fine. Yeah. So we're gonna see it in big chunks show up here. But this is going to once we do this, we'll need to update index.html a little bit to clean it up. But then we should be able to push this to bcgetpages, take a look at it ourselves, and then ask Google to index it. And then presumably the text pages that it's going to link. Oh, fuck. I forgot to link, didn't I? Yeah, that's not very useful. Of course, we want these to be hyperlinks. To what is our? We do have the file name, right? Yeah, we do. href equals fname list item slash a. Okay, and this time I'm going to run it without the without the t. So I won't actually see it. Or I want to screw things up so badly. So we're going to use Perl's function that lets us put quotation marks inside. Any character can be a quote character if you put QQ in front of it. So if this works, we should get what we need. If it doesn't, we won't. That's pretty simple. And I think less parses as well, too, so let's not. All right, so let's see. List ahref to this. All right, well, this might not work, but I mean, at least it's semi-solid. I'm going to look at it in the browser first, then I'm going to push it to GitHub Pages, and then we're going to have Google index it, and then we can just, And this is sort of the first piece of data that we're trying to get Google to index proactively. And the next, but we have other data too. We're gonna do this for some other data as well and get Google indexing that. Of course, now Google won't necessarily index stuff just because you tell it to, but at least we've put it into a format where Google could, in theory, index this. And we will have to edit the index page. This is not the complete index.html. This is just a little chunk of it. All right, so. Oh, that's not what I meant to do, but okay. Oh, that thing finished just as I was. So let's take a look at it the way it is now. And there's a couple of. We actually want to also maybe put, our current centuries, So this is nice. And I guess we actually want them to open stuff like this in a new tab. So, there's a way to do that. It's ahref target equals something. So we got a little bit of work to do here. And I can't remember if it's blank or new, but I do have it written down somewhere. So, blank. Target equals underscore blank. Okay, so we want to do that. Yeah, I'm trying to figure out a way to not have to run through each file all the time just to print out these. These values, these list items. I don't care too much though. And the fact that they say CE and BC inside, I think I'll allow that to be a point of confusion. Let's see. Maybe. Right. And I think the spacing here is probably not going to be ideal. I think Google's going to complain. It might complain that there's too many links on this page, too. In which case, I'll have to break. I'm beginning to understand now why people break up their pages instead of giving everyone data on one page. It's because Google sucks and makes them do it. I hate Google. We all hate Google. Yeah. All right. So. Now, of course, in theory, what the hell do I want to do? Oh, you know, in theory, I didn't even need to do that. I do need to BC get this, which I should have done a long time ago, because this is a new file and it was working. All right. But I'm pretty sure I can actually just change this using Emacs. So, you know, let's go to data, index.html. So here we can just say, wherever we have a close this thing, we can turn it into a target equals underscore blank this. So what does that do? Did that do what I wanted? No, it did not. Because I missed out on a quotation mark here. So I want to change quotation end to this. Not that one though. Is that correct? Okay. See what this does. So now if I do this, yes, it does open on a new tab, so that's fantastic. Okay, so now I'm kind of curious to see if just the way this is, Google is happy with indexing it. Because if the spacing is an issue, I need to fix that. If it's anything else, we could probably do that later. So let me go ahead and push BC get pages. And just to be clever, I'm going to make the commit comment stuff instead of the normal commit comment, which is checkpoint. So I've created a whole bunch of files here, but they're fairly small. 312, according to this, by the way. So it's going to take a little bit of time to push all this crap to GitHub pages. Currently, there's no link from our index page to this page. That's okay for now, because we don't necessarily want that. Let's see. Is it barrycarter.github.io? I really need to learn how to spell my name. It's a little bit distressing that I don't. To go, let's see if it's been pushed over. It is still being pushed over, so maybe this will not work. And I also think that this does not allow virtual directories. So let's see if this works. It does not. But that's okay, because it's still in the process of pushing stuff to GitHub, so this might take a little bit of time. So while it's doing that, let's talk about what we're going to be doing next. What kind of data are we going to be pushing next for Google to index? And I'm pretty sure I know what it's going to be. I mean, I am the one making that decision. And I want to make it, let's look at what large data we have here. And I think the next one's going to be conjunctions. I mean, that seems like the next big chunk of data that would want to be pushed. I think house states is going to be a little bit, yeah, this is going to be something that's not useful to people. It just tells you sort of all the house states. ASCII P, this thing is a Mathematica file, which probably doesn't actually belong here. HYG data, It's tempting, actually, to push that. And actually, I was thinking of conjunctions, which is apparently way down on the list here somewhere. There's someone else's data, but I don't really care about that. Let's see. Let's see, let's see, let's see. And I also want to know what the hell is all retrogrades. That's just a subset of what we have. So I also have the HIP2, the HIP, this is boring. All right, let's take a look at the HYG data real quick, because this is... I mean, some of this stuff is interesting, you know, especially for the stars that are fairly bright, but I don't know if it's interesting enough to post. So let's take a look at this. I saw some flickering here, but maybe I'm just losing my mind. Jupiter-Galilean eclipses, which someone's already should have already done, but you know. Let's take a look at that. Let's see what this is. Okay. So this is a very raw format, but we could parse this to say, you know, this is the star 1850, you know, Io enters partial eclipse. 504 actually is Callisto, I think, but whatever. Enters partial eclipse. The CP data is, of course, because I'm making assumptions about Io being about everything being spherical and Jupiter is not. And this is a different way of calculating what my data. And then, you know, enters total eclipse, and then leaves total eclipse and all this good stuff. This is a candidate. And let's quickly see how long this is. I mean, the whole point here is that it's too long to fit in as one file, and it clearly is. It's 743,000 lines. So we might actually, you know, break it up into, well, let's see. That for 20,000 lines on average per file, 37 files, covers a period of 150. So we could do this in like maybe 5 year periods or something. 1850 to 1855, you know, blah, 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 blah. Okay, it has now been pushed to BC Git pages. Doesn't necessarily mean it's going to show up. But, let's see, oh, this is shiny. Oh, that is shiny. I'm having a hard-on here. Nah, you heard me. Okay, so test live URL. Okay, that's fine. Wait. That should have actually asked me if I wanted to, switch properties, because now we're going back to the Maggie thing did not work really that well for us. Well, I mean, it did, but, we're done with it for now. Let's go ahead and test my live URL for me, please. Whoa! I mean, yes, that's very nice. Okay, cool. We will modify this a bit to you know, see what the hell it is, actually. Let's see. And I'll make a note to do that. BC Git pages. Dun, 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 dun. It is currently minimal. So I'm cheating, basically. I don't want to spend the time to do it right now. Make sure that did make it. Okay, yeah, okay. And okay. All right, so that we haven't finished, but we've done a pretty good job now of getting Google to index. I guess if we really wanted to be thorough, we could go over here wherever the hell we were, and click on one of these, maybe one of the ones that's more modern. And I notice it does say 0AD, and I'm going to allow that, even though technically no such thing. I mean, it does include 0AD because that doesn't exist. So now, I'm going to ask Google to inspect this URL. And of course, we're not going to go through all of these at one at a time. Google will decide whether to index them or not. But I mean, it's going to crawl eventually. This is just one of the examples we want to test to make sure Google thinks it's mobile friendly and generally fucked up the way it needs to be fucked up for Google to be happy. This is taking longer than I expect because it's a pretty short file. We made a point of making this pretty short. So I'm having some concerns now. Concerns are growing. Concerns are growing more. Okay, now I'm deeply concerned. Okay. Just panicked me for no good reason. Let's view the tested page. It's interesting they actually add HTML to it, even though it's a text file. That's just kind of bizarre. And it does look like it goes all the way. All right. Okay. So what we're going to do now is we're going to discuss the next, which we were talking about earlier, the next piece of data to put in there. Jupiter Galileo and eclipses is not a bad one. BC, this thing here, it has nothing to do with astronomy, but it is GCal's list of all holidays that I later filter through. Moon on eclipse day, not interesting. Earth on eclipse day, these are all for the lunar eclipse, the solar eclipse that occurred a while back. Star names and positions. I think I decided I couldn't use this because, because the oh, this is from Mathematica, actually. Okay, Pomodoro time, two and back in 2 and 2. And we are almost back. And we are back. Okay. So this isn't any good either. And I guess to avoid continuously jumping back and forth, I can use screen the way it's meant to be used. So the next one that is marches.txt. I don't know what the hell that is, and I don't know why it's here. Well, that's a list of the marches, one every year. Not interesting. I think the next interesting one is solstices and equinoxes. This is actually worth looking at. Okay. Let's see. This list the solstices, as you can see, this list the solstices, this is give or take 15,000 years, and I get the feeling I could almost use the same, similar what I did to for the astrological houses, because this is very, the format's very, it's not identical, but it is similar. And I probably should shave off the last sec. No, you know what? I'll keep it. That's, I mean, this actually technically has, you know, partial seconds. So this basically shows how the solstices and the have moved over time. Now the real question is anyone else doing this? I don't think they are, actually, to be honest. I think this might be, so for the year 2000, I'm sure we have this somewhere. This we should find something in Google. This I would expect to see something in Google. Holy crap. I really need to change this page also, but let's see if we have this. Alright, maybe we have it like this. Oh, wow. Wow. The only thing I can think of is they don't have it in this format. They have it like, you know. Wait. What? This is the wrong era, isn't it? Because in the year 2000... Yeah, let's not do that. A.D.2000, but I think there's too many spaces there. I'm going to get sick of this in a second. Okay, yeah, there we go, sorry. This is what I would expect to see, because this is fairly modern, and I think this is this enough people use this time format that it would be meaningful. There we go. Interesting. Interesting. Okay, I mean, yeah, this is kind of what I expected. I don't think anyone goes as far back or as far forward as I do, but we can test for that by looking at... let's see if anybody does that. And if they don't, we're not putting new stuff onto the internet. This is already on the internet. But we are putting new stuff into Google. Assuming this doesn't turn up anything. Yep. So you are adding to the value of Google. Not really. We're adding to the worthlessness of Google by putting in data that is extremely not useful to anyone. Okay. Okay, what I'd like to do is let's go ahead and parse the solstice data. Actually, hang on. I've been going for close to 3 hours now. I rock. The only weird thing here, by the way, is that pretty sure this is the winter solstice in the Northern Hemisphere, but it doesn't actually say, so I've got to be a little bit careful. I mean, my order starts at winter, spring, summer, fall, winter again, so on and so forth. Of course, we don't need this the ephemeris time, but that's okay. Yeah, okay. So I think we've got a good plan here to how we're going to be, how we're going to parse this solstices and equinoxes file and add some information to the universe that is useless. Let me quickly, since I don't want to spend, I want to get over 5 hours because somehow that is important to me. What the hell's planet? I don't think this is anything interesting either, but let's take a look real quick. Wow. These are, I think, under Wikidata, all the things that are considered planets, or apparently moons as well, but that's interesting. I'm pretty sure the brightness files here are actually for something else entirely. And hopefully one of the things in here is the phase angle. Although it doesn't really matter. Yeah, these files are here so we could try to compute the phase curves of various different planets. Spice files ping is a hideous file that no one wants to see. March is mixed. I don't know why I'm looking. I think this is just sorted in random order, but why? Why? Okay, it's not. What the hell is Z-Dump? I mean, come on. Wait, what? Oh. Okay, that's BZ-less. Oh, this is a Z-Dump of all the time zones. Okay. Boy. Tesla brightness, sun brightness, equator from GeoCenter, Tycho Guide, Ecliptic, Lange 3. I have a lot of crap in here. Wow. Oh, this is the ecliptic longitude of various stars that are above 6.5 magnitude. So this actually, I think, helps me paint one of the images that I have here. Sunrise at multiple latitudes. I get the feeling that's more, again, for testing. Oh, yeah, this is, again, probably for testing. Okay. Some array data. That's fantastic the way I'm doing this shit. Constellation boundaries is not something I created. SC2001-2100. I'm pretty sure that's... Oh, that's solar equinoxes. Earth symbol, TZ file. Okay, so apparently... the conjunction stuff, I guess, I have somewhere else, which actually probably makes sense. Because I probably have it in BC Info 3 and don't want to repeat it anywhere. Are there issues? I think I fixed that, actually. Let's see. Read me. Okay. Oh, okay, so it's Astro. It's in a database somewhere. Where's the okay. This I should actually be able to get to from I think it's search.astro.barrycarter.info. Ooh, shiny. Cooler ones, where's the whole list? There, oh. Oh. God damn, this is a weird place to put it. Okay, let me go ahead and copy this link. I should have that somewhere. But anyway. Is next. So that's the one we can also do. So the solstices, and also solstices is next. So I'll probably do solstices next, and after that the conjunctions. And let's... I'm going to try to hit 3 hours just because I'm such a complete a-hole. So we're about 40 seconds away from 3 hours. And let me see if I do have that somewhere else. I could have sworn I had that in BC Git Astro. And I'm surprised that I don't. It's not that big of a file. Whoa. Yo mama. Wow. That's... I'm kind of... I guess, I mean, I don't really need it, but at the same time... It's not that big of a file. It really should be there. Okay, I should probably be unhappy about this. Oh, wait a minute. It might also be... Hang on, okay. Where did I put this damn thing? Test? Yeah, it might actually be here. Huh. the hell is it in capital? No. Okay, I'm probably a little bit annoyed that that's not. It's not that big of a file. It should be. It's 22.7 megabytes. There's something funky going on here that I'm not seeing. Let me see if I can find out. Okay, let me take a real quick look here. Okay. Oh. Wow. I really should just add it, but okay. Screw that. Okay, I think that easily takes us into 3 hours and 1 minute. Thank you for watching the stream. I may be back later today to do the 2 follow-up things we're doing to put more garbage into Google. Thank you for watching, and goodbye for now.